Hello students, welcome in 10th standard subject Maths, chapter 1, Real Number. Here we are going to start this chapter. As in the chapter, some introduction is given that we can read in the textbook, and it is for our general knowledge. You can understand about the Euclid's and his work done in Maths. Here the first thing to know in this chapter is theorem 1.1. It is Euclid's division lemma. This concept till 9th standard it is not introduced anywhere else. This is directly starting this standard 10th Maths. So if you don't know anything before it, don't bother about it, because it starts right now in 10th standard only. Okay, to understand it very easy it is, but we have to keep patience in our mind to understand it, and once you will understand, you will also think that so much easy concept is this. So Euclid's division lemma, its statement is, given positive integers a and b, that is, you know that positive integers may be any positive integers a and b, if two positive integers are given, then there exist unique positive unique integers q and r, two more integers you will find which are satisfying a equals to b q plus r, where r will have the condition 0 or greater than that but less than b. In this statement it looks like from where this form comes and what is this relation. Okay, understand it, we have to take some example here. So first example I have taken, like in the statement given positive integers a and b. So I am taking a equals to 100 and b equals to 24 are given two positive integers, because positive integers I have taken two positive integers, and these are given in the statement also. So given that means you can take any two positive integers. It's not necessary that you also have to take 124, you can take any two positive integers. Now we have to see that which positive integer is greater than the other. So here you can understand 100 is greater than 24, right? So because the heading is Euclid's division lemma, so division comes in this division. As we know, in 124, who will divide? 100 will be divisible by 24. We have to divide 100 by 24. Simple it is, simple maths. Okay, if you divide 100 by 24, 24 divides 100. 24, 4s are 96. 100 minus 96 will give 4. Now assign these numbers to this to get this form. The dividend 100 is denoted by a, which was given number. First given number by which we have divided, that is divisor, is denoted by b. It was also given two given positive integers here we have. Now by dividing, we are getting two more integers. This is quotient 4 and remainder here. So as it was given, there exists unique integers q and r. So from where this q and r comes, q means quotient here 4 in this example, and r is remainder. That is also 4 in this example we are getting. Now, 4 numbers we have, 4 integers we have. 100, 24, 2 were given, and 4, 4 we found by division, quotient and remainder. Now we want to convert this in linear form. In linear form you can understand 100 equals 24 into 4 plus 4. What we have done? A equals divisor is B into quotient is 4 plus remainder. 24, 4s are 96 and 400 will be. So this is in this form we can write A equals to BQ plus R, that is this part of the theorem we get. Now what about this part? For this part also, in this only example, here you get remainder R equals to 4. R equals to 4, that is R greater than 0 we got, right? Second thing, r equals to 4 we have, that is always less than 24. You can understand that divisor will be always greater than remainder, or inversely the remainder will be always less than divisor. So 4 is less than 24. Then what is that implies? 24 equals to b we have. So what is the relation between r and b? R is always less than b, means remainder is always less than divisor. So this r is less than b and r is greater than 0. We can compute, we can combine in these both. R will be always greater than or equal to 0, but always less than b. Now the question will be in our mind that r is greater than 0. So why we are writing r is greater than 0 or equal to 0 also? So we take one more example here. If we take given two positive integers as a equals to 100 if I take and b equals to 25. Two positive integers this time I have taken 125. A similar way we go, 100 is greater than 25. So 100 will be divided by 25. 25 fours are 100. Right? So 100 minus 100 is 0. Again we assign all things the similar way. The dividend as a, divisor as b, quotient as q and remainder as r. Here you can see that remainder is 0. As you know that sometimes you will get when the number will be divisible by the other one, divisor, the remainder comes 0 also. Right? So in this part also if we convert it in linear form, so 100 equals 25 into 4, 25 fours are 100 plus remainder is 0. So again the form will be 100 is a considered as equals to 25 is b into 4 is q and plus remainder r equals to 0, so 0 equals to r. So again we got a equals to bq plus r. This form we got in this example also. In all examples you will get the same. Now here you can understand that r may be 0 also, but always less than divisor. So this less than or equal to sign comes. 0 less than or equal to 0. In this case actually, perfectly if you see, 0 is less than or equal to 0. That is 0 is equal to 0 here we have. And but 0 is less than 25. So here we write. Now by notations if we go, 0 is less than or equal to this 0 is r, and it is less than b is 25 in this case. So do you understand this condition also? So this is the very easy thing in the chapter, and this is the very first concept in our chapter. So it's very easy. Always you have to find this form by simple division. In examples we will do, in exercise also we will do the same. That's by simple division you will get this form, and for the remainder r equals to